A final thought about longtime KSTP Chief Meteorologist Dave Dahl. He's retiring this week. We are saying goodbye to a good friend who has served the people of Minnesota for more than 43 years. Tonight, the first in a series of stories looking back at his career. And Dave and I begin at the beginning. How did you get interested in meteorology? It was a, if I recall, it was a big tornado over.
Yeah, it was a huge tornado. It was the largest one that's ever happened here in the Twin Cities proper. There were about six tornadoes that came through the metro May 6th of 1965. Boy, that one night, because I was in a house that didn't have a basement. So I had four brothers and sisters, and we all just kind of huddled up in the center part of our home. It lasted for what seemed like forever for me.
You went to study meteorology at Florida State. Dr. Walt Lyons hires you at KSTP. How old were you?
At that time, I was 23, just out of college.
Dave worked behind the scenes on what was then billed as the largest television weather service in the world. That's him in the back. He got his big break in 1979 when an on-air meteorologist got sick.
And they said, Dave, do you own a suit? We need you to be on TV. And I said, I don't even own a suit.
There's a corridor through the Twin Cities. It seems to be...
And the rest is TV history.
How many forecasts do you think you've done?
I've never even thought about it. But, you know, 43 and a half years is quite a few.
I grew up watching Dave Dahl, and don't tell him, Matt, that I was a kid when I first saw him.
We're going to see the temperatures remain fairly mild.
Meteorologist Jonathan Juhas and I did some brainstorming, and we estimate, at a minimum, Dave has done around 42,000 weather forecasts on air, and the number's more than 60,000 when you count his radio forecasts.
Dave's a legend in this business. He's been doing this for a long time, but not only that, is people all over the country know who he is, and they really, really appreciate and admire his style.
Favorite part about your job?
The people. I think meeting people and knowing that, you know, they're relying on a forecast that I put out.
What is your least favorite part of the job?
My least favorite, I think, is the stress of severe weather. You know, even though I know that it's important, my least favorite part is I know lives are being interrupted.
One thing I admire about you is that you're not afraid to change the forecast.
It changes all the time. So you've got to kind of put your ego aside here and say, you know what? It's not going to happen. That isn't going to happen. So we're going to change that.
How has putting a forecast together changed over the years?
Oh, yeah, just tremendously. Because of the equipment, we want to be more specific than we've ever been before.
Because your forecast is everybody's hometown forecast.
Absolutely, and that's why we have to kind of touch on all those specific areas, which has gotten a lot more difficult, but the models then are much more specific as well.
What are you looking forward to most about retirement?
I think it's just mainly sitting back and relaxing and enjoying family. You know, I'll have much more time to enjoy my daughter. I love all my kids. I've got a lot of kids. I've got seven kids and six grandkids, so I'm enjoying life.
And now they'll get to see more of you.
Yeah, Grandpa will be around a little bit more.
And tomorrow, the biggest weather moments of the past 43 years and how they impacted Dave and all of us in the state of Minnesota. Thanks so much for joining us for Nightcast tonight. Jimmy Kimmel Live is up next. 5 Eyewitness News is back at 4:30. Hope you have a good night. See you tomorrow.